give this man a champion letter first of all to mind our sin, and then against God and one another. And let us now beg God's pardon and peace. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. King to call sinners, Christ have mercy. You are sitting at the right hand of the Father who intercedes for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God.
For your sake, I bear insult, and shame covers my face. But death reigned from Adam to Moses, even over those who did not sin after the pattern of the trespass of Adam, who is the type of the one who was to come. But the gift is not like the transgression. For if by the transgression of the one the many died, how much more did the grace of God and the gracious gift of the one man, Jesus Christ, overflow for the many? The word of the Lord.
As he tells us, we must strive to speak in the light Methodist community struggles to proclaim the gospel within a culture that rejected them and their values. That by the time Matthew's gospel was written, many Christians had already given their lives to martyrdom for the faith. Yes. Proclaim this truth as Jesus. we will speak and live the word of God, even if what we say is rejected by others. As one author writes, the church remains because God counts our prayer and notices when a sparrow falls. Continue to extend grace to those who will accept and appropriate that grace is the source of our strength and our stamina. That grace enables us to live by faith and not by fear. As I said at the beginning, fear imprisons, faith liberates. Fear paralyzes, faith empowers. Fear disheartens, faith encourages. Let us remember these words of Jesus presented to us today. Everyone who acknowledges me before others, I will acknowledge before my heavenly Father. Whoever denies me before others, I will deny before my heavenly Father. Thus Jesus says to each one of us, to live a life of faith, to be willing to speak the truth always, to proclaim this truth from the Word of God. In other words, to proclaim the Word of God, no matter the cost. Please join me now in our profession of faith. Together, I believe in one God.
Grace to the peaceful resolution of conflicts in the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of your Son, Jesus. May we open our hearts to his presence so that we may share that love with one another always. We make this our prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received you. The wine and the bread we offer you, fruit of the body, fruit of the work of our earth and the work of human hands, it will become for us our bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and the fruit of the man. It will become our spiritual drink. Bring our dear brothers and sisters in Christ that my sacrifice is yours, may be acceptable to God the Almighty God.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands, the praise of the Lord in his name, for our good and for all his holy good.
Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and prayer, and grant that cleansed by this action, we may make offering of our heart pleasing to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
He is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining from you, a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, the time he went to pray and entered willingly into his passion, he took breath and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In the similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.